Well, hi, my name's Sally McLean. I've been a member of this church for about 12 years. It's great to have an opportunity to talk about my faith. It started for me in February 1982, when I was a young mother with two children and expecting a third one. It may have been the hormones, it may have been my background, because my mother was an actress, my aunt was an actress, so I could have been overdramatic, but one evening I felt very down and I stormed out of the house in Blackheath, took the train up to Charing Cross, and I went into St. Martin in the Fields, which is, you may know, is a church known for its ministry to the homeless. And I just felt that that was where I belonged. I belonged with the down and outs. And I sat there in the cold, damp, dark sort of environment for some time. And then a member of the clergy got up and read something. And I wish I could remember what he read, but I just suddenly knew that God loved me. And it wasn't as if I knew that God was love or that God loved everybody, but it was particularly that God loved me. And I was quite surprised, really, because I hadn't been looking for God. That wasn't why I'd gone into the church. I was very pleased, and I thought, this just changes absolutely everything for me. I had a feeling of self-worth, which really changed my life, and the depression that had dogged me for many years was gone. Just gone. Later on, God gave me what they sometimes call a burden for these people called the Karen of Myanmar, who suffer very badly under the military regime. And I was able to go out and visit them, and the time and the money were found for that. And it became something that I still continue to do now. While I was living in Brussels, there were two prophecies that were given by a man who was organizing the March for Jesus then. And one of them was, he said, from your hands will flow a great deal of money for the poor. And that has been true, because depends, I suppose, what you think of as a great deal of money, but our charity has continued to raise funds every year, and we've really helped the IDPs in Karen and Kareni State and now Chin State, and the refugees in Thailand, and also the ex-servicemen in Burma, Myanmar, from the Burma campaign. And the other prophecy was that I would go to high places. At the time I thought, well, you know, I'm a housewife, not very well educated. I've never had a job that paid very well. It doesn't seem very likely that I'll go to high places. But a couple of years ago, I was given the MBE by the now King Charles, but he was then Prince Charles, for my work with the veterans from the Burma campaign. So both those things came true. But I should also tell you that in the last 12 years, my faith has been tested, if you like, or I've had to draw very close to God to deal with quite hard things that have happened. 12 years ago, my marriage of 40 years broke down. And then 7 years ago, my oldest daughter, who was a doctor and married and the mother of two boys, died of kidney cancer. And then 2 years ago, her husband died. So the two boys, who are now 15 and 17, live with me and my second daughter. So this has been quite a lot, but I can honestly say that God has not abandoned me. He's always been with me through these trials, And I'd also like to say that my home group and the Christian community I belong to have been absolutely wonderful in supporting me. That's all I wanted to say. I think I've packed quite a lot in.